The War of the Rebellion is often considered one of the first modern wars. It is important to note that many of the accomplishments that made the War of the Rebellion modern predate the War of the Rebellion, and technically, the Crimean War deserves the title far more. However, the War of the Rebellion was special in that troops were much quicker and more frequently shuffled around the country to deal with emerging crises. The vast railroad network of the United States permitted the movement of troops and helped in alter the face of war. This will be a 5-episode series looking at troop movement. This episode focuses on the movements of Andrew Jackson Smith's corps, often called General A.J. Smith's guerrillas. Jackson Smith was a career military man of the regular army. He graduated from West Point in 1838 and served on the western frontier for the next 2 decades. By the outbreak of the rebellion, he was a major in the regulars. He remained for much of the early war west of the Mississippi, with initial command being the 2nd California Volunteer Cavalry, and then assuming command of the cavalry forces in the Department of the Missouri. By the time of the Vicksburg Campaign, Smith commanded a division. It was 1864 that Smith and his 2 divisions would gain most of their fame. 1864 promised to be a busy year for campaigning. Ulysses Grant had worked out an intricate plan to prevent the rebel forces from concentrating like they had done in Shiloh or Chickamauga. He was going to strike in 5 different locations almost simultaneously, hoping the enemy would break in one of them, and the break could bring about victory. One of the 5 campaigns was to see Major General Nathaniel P. Banks' Army of the Gulf advance against Mobile, closing the last remaining Gulf port to blockade runners. However, with the French presence in Mexico, Abraham Lincoln's government wanted to also make a show of force towards Texas. Before the campaign against Mobile, Banks received orders to advance up the Red River into Texas. Smith, with 2 divisions, joined Banks on this ill-fated undertaking. On March 10, Banks set his amphibious expedition in motion. David Dixon Porter was a river fleet, and Smith joined from Vicksburg and met up with Banks in the vicinity of Alexandria. Smith's men won the opening engagement of the campaign when they surprised, after a night's march, the rebel forces at Fort DeRussy. While Smith waited for 6 days for the rest of the army to arrive, he dealt the rebel forces another defeat. Banks, however, felt the pressure of having to return Smith to Sherman in time for the Atlanta campaign. Smith and his men were not involved in Banks' defeat at the Battle of Mansfield on April 7. However, it was Smith's men making a stand and counterattacking the enemy at the Battle of Pleasant Hill on April 9 that protected the retreat of Banks' army. Upon the completion of the Red River campaign, it was too late for the strike against Mobile, and Banks' force was too exhausted to engage in any campaigning in the near future. As a result, Smith took his 2 divisions up the Mississippi to Memphis. He was also too late to join William T. Sherman on the Atlanta campaign, but he could still provide his former colleagues some valuable assistance, protecting the supply lines in Middle Tennessee. The main goal of these operations was to keep Nathan Bedford Forrest distracted in northern Mississippi and out of Middle Tennessee, where his cavalry could do major damage to the supply lines of the Atlanta campaign. In conjunction with a cavalry detachment under Benjamin Grierson, Smith advanced with his two divisions into northern Mississippi and faced Forrest in the Battle of Tupelo on July 14 and 15, 1864. Smith's advance into northern Mississippi had been unchecked until his men reached Pontotoc. Forrest was finally ready to offer opposition. Smith had taken up an entrenched position near Harrisburg. Forrest's men attacked, dismounted, but faced stiff resistance with bloody repulses suffered by the rebel horsemen. After a few unproductive attacks, rebels withdrew and entrenched on their own. Smith refused to attack, instead did damage to the infrastructure in the region. Once Smith determined he had done enough, he decided to withdraw. Forrest's men followed on his heels. Despite not destroying Forrest's cavalry, Smith had mauled them badly enough that they never went up against infantry again in battle. Having dealt with the threat in northern Mississippi, Smith's two divisions needed new employment. And with a new crisis, Smith continued his role of firefighter in the West. When the corps that Smith was part of officially ceased to exist on November 7, 1864, Smith and his two units became homeless, or officially called Detachment Army of the Tennessee. With Sterling Price wreaking havoc in Missouri, Smith engaged in a wild pursuit of the rebel marauders. Once Price's rebels were chased out of Missouri, Smith again needed to go elsewhere. After the fall of Atlanta, John Bell Hood's small defeated army decided to take the war into Middle Tennessee to force Sherman out of Georgia. Sherman stayed put and let George Henry Thomas and the Army of the Cumberland deal with Hood. After stalling actions at Franklin, the two sides were ready for battle outside of Nashville. Smith reinforced Thomas's besieged army and helped win the Battle of Nashville. Since Hood's army was too small to surround Nashville, Thomas had a few opportunities to attack the enemy. He put Smith and Wilson on the far edge of the army, aiming to swing against the rebel redoubts on the rebel left. Smith, together with Wilson's cavalry, was able to quickly overrun four redoubts. Hood withdrew his forces to a new line, which Smith and the other corps of Thomas's army assaulted the following day. The rout of the once proud rebel army of Tennessee was complete, and Smith's detached troops played a significant role in the victory at Nashville. On February 18, 1865, Smith's Corps came back into existence with three divisions. Their stay in Nashville, however, was brief. They were needed elsewhere. Down the Mississippi they once more went to join the new commander of the Department of the Gulf, Major General Edward R.S. Canby, to attack Mobile. The Corps fought valiantly at Spanish Fort and Fort Blakely. The end of the war brought the unit's final disbandment on July 20, 1865. Andrew Jackson Smith's troops were a fire brigade in the Western Theater during the last year of the war. Having gained significant fighting experience in Vicksburg, the troops were not part of the pivotal Atlanta campaign, but their actions along the Red River, in northern Mississippi, Missouri, Nashville, and Mobile helped pave the way to victory. Like with the other units in this series, without the speedy steamship and railroads, as well as the telegraph, Smith's units would likely not have been able to make such a rapid movement around the region. They are another illustration of this modern war and how important troop movements were to bring about victory.
Thank you for watching this episode of the War of the Rebellion channel. If you liked the material covered, please like and subscribe to the channel. Hit the notification bell for new episodes. If there's a story of the War of the Rebellion you would like covered, please leave a comment. Use the comments to engage in conversations. Thank you for patronizing the War of the Rebellion channel.